an independent samples t-test in SPSS. Are women more willing to donate to a fundraiser than men? If they do, they would have higher average willingness to donate than men. In SPSS, we can compare the means of two groups with the independent samples t-test. In SPSS, we can find the independent samples t-test under compare means. We have to select the numeric variable for which we want to compare means. In this example, we'll take willingness to donate at the end of the experiment. Then we have to identify the groups, the two groups that we want to compare. This is the sex variable, and as we can see here in the background, we have 0 for males and then probably 1 for females. We've defined the groups and we can have a look at the options. We'll get the 95% confidence interval, which is fine. We can do bootstrapping. There's another video explaining that. So basically, we are ready. Let's paste and run the command. Here is the output. First, we get some group statistics and we see we have 71 males in our sample and 72 females. The average willingness to donate for males is 4.2, which is below the average willingness of females, which is 5. Now, these are the numbers in this sample, but can we conclude that there is a difference in the population as well? So we go to the test table. First of all, we have to find out whether we may assume that there are equal population variances. Is the variance in willingness to donate among men in the population equal to the variance in the willingness to donate of females in the population? The F-test is not statistically significant. The p-value is 0.85. So we may not reject the null hypothesis of equality of variances. So equal variances in the population are possible, and we will have to interpret the top row in this table, equal variances assumed. The test result, t is minus 3.2 with 141 degrees of freedom with a p-value of 0.002, which is well below 0.05, so we would reject the null hypothesis that males and females have the same average willingness to donate in the population. The difference, the mean difference in the sample is minus 0.9, which has a 95% confidence interval ranging from minus 1.4 to minus 0.3. So with 95% confidence, we may conclude that in the population, the difference between males and females is 1.4 to 0.3. And the females have the higher average. Now, how about the assumptions for using the t-distribution? If our samples are larger than 30, we can always use the t-distribution in a test of one or more means. In this example, we have 71 males in our sample, that's much more than 30, 72 females, so we are fine, we can use the t-distribution. If our sample would have been much smaller, below 30, we would have to assume that the variable, willingness to donate, is normally distributed in the population, both for males and females. We can't really check that. We can make some histograms with willingness, our variable, selected, and one histogram for each sex, displaying the normal curve. And we can eyeball those histograms, but if the sample is really low, say below 30, the sample distribution usually is not nicely normal, even if the distribution in the population is normal. So it's difficult to check the distribution in the population, and we really have to make an assumption that the distribution is normal in the population.